Hey everyone, breakfast vlog for Thursday the 13th of September 2018. Coming to you from the Standard Fare. This week is no gym week. I think I'm overtrained. I think that's why I'm just... Sometimes your body just shuts down and says, that's it. I've had enough of your shenanigans. And I don't know, either that or, you know, something, some wave went through me or whatever on Friday last week. And because it was like straight, you know, up, and then it's just been a slow decline, and now I'm, you know, among the living, but the last couple days have been, you know, very discomforting would be the only word I could describe it, because there's no mechanical injury. I haven't changed my diet so drastically that I would have, you know, like all of a sudden I'm in another city and I'm eating other foodstuffs dramatically, like, you know, I have to eat McDonald's or something. So it's not that. I don't know. And I'm trying to identify a cause, and I'm thinking about the planet and the tumultuous season we seem to be in, and I'm like, well, okay, maybe I'm connected with the planet, maybe I'm just, you know, going with the flow, you know. And like I always say to everybody when I'm, you know, training at the gym, you can't have 365 good days a year. You just can't. So I like these bad times, these injury times, these, you know, down times to make me appreciate the really good times more. So I guess, in a way, it's a kind of a blessing in disguise. It's like getting a flat tire but not losing the tire. You know, you're able to, like, just patch it and refill it instead of having to buy a whole new tire. I mean, it's a sucky situation. You've got your flat, you know, you've lost all that time and everything, you had to change a tire, but then it only ended up being a $50 job instead of a $150 job. So, you know, sometimes you gotta look at it that way. So I guess I'll just have to look at it that way because there's no other way to look at it. You know, I can moan and drip and suck my thumb, I suppose. But then again, there's other people doing that. And I'll segue right into what I wanted to kind of sort of hit on. And because I made a comment on it yesterday. A fella. Had made a caricature drawing of Serena Williams after her temper tantrum, which it absolutely was. It was an absolute temper tantrum. It was somebody's cheese slipping off the cracker. And I made a comment because everybody's going like how racist this comment was or this cartoon was. And if you've ever looked at caricature drawings, like, you know, I remember when we were kids and my parents had some dude do drawings of my brother and I, and it was supposed to be a reputable artist, but you'd think they were caricatures, you know. They got buried somewhere, you know. My brother he doesn't even want it on the wall. He would freak out if he saw it, you know. And I can understand if you're the person, you see the caricature of yourself and you're like, ah, okay, but it wasn't racist. Yeah. You were called out, basically, and now you're embarrassed, and that's all it is. So you're just trying to figure out a way to get out from underneath the bus. And, hey, I don't blame you for that, and that's what I said in the comment. I said, because it's just her, you know, basically stomping up and down in a temper tantrum, which kids do. They have temper tantrums. I've seen temper tantrums. I don't think my kids have ever had them, like an all-out now, you know, stomping up and down in Walmart with their screaming and yelling. I've seen them, but not mine. But that's what that was. So, and that's all the picture was just a caricature of her doing that. And the comment that I made, if it was race, or I didn't say anything. I think the paraphrase of my own comment would be, she wasn't drawn with a bone in her nose and a spear instead of a racket. That would have been a racist caricature. That would have been racist, you know. Other than that, it was just a large black woman having a temper tantrum. She is big. Let's not get and her hair was interesting. Let's say, I used to have a top knot like that, and people used to make fun of me all the time. My kids were just mortified. So let's not throw too much into this one. And if you think about caricatures and what they're about and everything like that, if you can't see that, then I can't help you. And if you want to look at bad caricature drawings, they just go through the hit. Like, I was watching Grease the other day, and at the beginning of the movie, when they do the cartoon part, when they're introducing the characters, you know, Sandra D and all that, and I think they're singing the song, Grease is the Word, blah blah blah. Anyway, they're all caricatures, and they're not flattering. The only flattering one is the Olivia Newton-John caricature, because she's gorgeous and you can't really screw that up. But the John Travolta, the Jeff Conway, the Stockard Channing is made to look, it's horrible. If I was her, I would have probably wanted the movie banned. You know, just that part, or sort of cut that out and say, okay, that's a horrible, but that's what a caricature is. It's not a true representation of the person. So, you know, you can take, wow, that doesn't make my ears look too good or my nose. I mean, if they had a caricature of me, I'd have one because I have a pulled out ear. So they would make this ear probably straight out, and my nose, because my nose is broken, bent. And, you know, I've got, you know, so it'd be just horrific. Big honking nose, one turned out ear, and it'd be crooked. So it wouldn't be too flattering, I'm sure. But yeah, like, come on. Manufactured outrage? At its finest. At its absolute finest. I mean, if you really are getting your panties in a bunch or your underwear in a bunch, men and women, white or black, tall or short, tennis player, not tennis player, if you're getting your panties in a bunch about this, then I can't help you. And no, I don't think anybody can help you. And that's what another thing I noticed too, that it's gotten to that point. There's no talking. He's a racist, you know. And then you look at all the other caricature drawings that this fella had done, and some of them aren't flattering either to other people. And nobody cared. Nobody cares. Nobody cares. Well, that's not true. So enough people do care. In the social internet toilet, that it's an issue, you know. So anyway, I'll put that to bed. It's a joke. It's a nothing burger. Let it go. With any doubt, you know, if I was talking about distraction about Syria yesterday, though, I didn't even think about the Serena Williams thing. I mean, it's actually getting more traction than the hurricane, you know. And I'm watching that too as well. It seems to have petered off a bit. You know, I've read a lot of papers on weather modification and such, and you know, they were calling for that Cat 4, Cat 5 coming in, it's going to destroy everything, and then all of a sudden now it's Cat 3, maybe Cat 2, and it's going to slow, and, you know, and a lot of people are looking at this, so I'm just going to stand back and watch and see what happens, but seems to be a lot of wind. I just looked on Ventusky just before I started making this video, just to have a look, and I went on a couple other places just to see if anything's going on in Syria. I can't find anything about that, so well, hopefully that all the squawking about Syria will put the plans on the back burner to destroy and kill more civilians. We can only hope. But for those of you down in Fayetteville and Wilmington and or whatever, and all that area right down there where that's coming home, boy, oh boy, oh boy. I mean, you got 80 mile an hour winds coming on shore right now, according to Ventusky. Seems to be a pretty good software package on the internet. It's free. You can just go on and it shows you wind speed and stuff. It's pretty cool. Good animation anyway. But you know, stay safe. Flooding, water. I imagine it'll be the flooding and the surging coming from the ocean. That'll be the big problem. If the winds have died down, if it's below, like at one point it was like 140 or 120. Now it's down to 80. So, you know, I know it's still nasty, but there's a big difference between 140 and 80 mile an hour, you know, just driving your car and you'll know. You're like, holy crap, you know, you even feel scared when you're driving 140 kilometers an hour, depending, or, is that miles or, yeah, miles. Oof, sorry, I was talking kilometers, so it's like, wow, oh, 80 miles, ooh, that's crazy. But I have driven 140 miles an hour. Yes, I have. So, yes, and I've driven 156 miles an hour on my motorcycle. That's the fastest I've ever gone on a land vehicle. 156 miles an hour, and boy oh boy, was life pass by fast when you're going that speed. Or it can end real quick if you get stopped real fast at that speed. I was on a motorcycle too, so. But I don't know what that is, but we'll end the video. Rambling anyway. Peace to you and yours. Hope to see you on the flip side.